God bless, Mom. My name is Judy Ann Sandy Altobar from Bachelor of Science in Social Work, first year Black Sea. So for today's video, I will going to answer the three questions that you provided for us. Question number one, what are the differences between gender equality and gender equity? It is necessary for the achievement of human rights. As society develops more successfully in all areas when both sexes have access to equal opportunities. Equal rights in decision-making, health, politics, the economics, the professions, and other sectors will undoubtedly propel our society forward. Everyone in a society has the right to conduct their lives as they see fit, free from prejudice. Equality is described as a state in which everyone is treated equally regardless of caste, gender, race, profession, or social status. Gender equity involves fair treatment for men and women based on their particular needs. Equity may also be defined as a situation in which all people have the same rights and have an equal chance to grow and thrive. So second question is, why is it necessary to know the differences of transgender to transsexual? To prevent becoming perplexed, we must first comprehend the distinctions between the transgender and transsexual. Transsexual is a term that falls within the transgender umbrella and is used to describe people who have a gender other than the one assigned at birth. Transgender can make mean different things to different people. Transgender people use a number of terminology to define their gender identity. Transsexual is a term that has been used historically and medically to indicate a change in one's gender identity, their internal experience of gender and sex assigned at birth, male, female, or intersex. So the last question is, what is the difference between direct and indirect discrimination? Direct discrimination occurs when someone is treated unfairly because of a protected characteristics, such as sex or ethnicity. For example, since she is a woman may be passed over for a promotion, and the job may be given to a less qualified man. An example of indirect discrimination is a minimum height requirement for a position where height is unrelated to the rule. Because women and the other minority ethnic groups are often shorter than men, such a criteria would disproportionately affect them. So that's all for today's video. Lastly, I am Judy Ann Sandy Altobar from Bachelor of Science in Social Work, first year Black Sea. Thank you and God bless.